So there is a problem with the centralized barrier, and that is that when the count has become zero, if these guys immediately are allowed to go on executing before the count has been reset to N, then they can all reach the next barrier and then they fall through. And that is a problem. So the key thing to do to avoid this problem or to overcome this problem is to make sure that the threads that are waiting here, they don't leave the barrier before the count has been reset to N. Right? So they're all waiting here for the count to become zero. And once the count has become zero, they're ready to go, but we don't want to let them go yet. We want to let them go only after the count has been reset to N. So what we're going to do is we're going to add another spin loop here. And that is after they recognize that the count has become zero, they're going to wait till the count is not N yet. And so this ordering of these two statements is very important, obviously. So we want to wait till the count has become zero. At that point, we know that the barrier is over, but we want to make sure that the counter has been reset to N by the last guy. And once that has been done, then we are ready to go on executing the code that we need to execute till we get to the next barrier. So we solved the problem with the first version of the centralized barrier, and that is the counting barrier, by having a second spin loop. That's the problem, right? There are two spin loops for every barrier in the counting algorithm. And ideally, we would like to have a single spin loop. And that's the reason that we have this particular algorithm, which is called sense reversing barrier. If you recall, in the counting barrier, we needed two spinning episodes. The first spinning episode was when you arrive at the barrier, you decrement the count and wait for the count to become zero. That's the first spinning episode. And the second spinning episode, to leave the barrier, what you needed to do was to make sure that the count has become N, right? Those were the two spinning episodes that were there in the counting barrier. And in the sense reversal barrier, we're going to get rid of one of those spinning episodes, the arrival one. We'll get rid of it. So we don't have to spin on count becoming zero. And we'll see how that is done. So what you notice is that in addition to the count, there is a sense variable. In the shared variables that we have, we included a new variable called sense variable that's also shared by all the processors that want to accomplish a barrier synchronization. And the idea behind the sense variable is that the sense variable is going to be true for one barrier episode, and it's going to be false for the next barrier. So because we, at most, you have one barrier at a time, and therefore, if we call this barrier as a true barrier, the next barrier is going to be the false barrier. So that's the way we can identify which barrier we are in at any particular point of time, so far as a given thread is concerned, by looking at the sense variable.